will be from Sacramento, homeless organizing committee, Nikki. Cat Pal.
Hey folks. Yeah. Who's ready to like fight back in the class war?
Yeah.
I'll try again. Who's ready to fight back in the class war? Yeah, because it's being waged against us, right? We don't have to start it. It's happening. Yeah, and what we've seen with this new iteration of the same white supremacist, patriarchal, capitalist power is just an elevation, an escalation. 6.2 billion in funding cuts to HUD. A system already in crisis, a housing system already totally incapable, totally without the capacity to take care of the folks who are in need of housing. And here we have this huge, devastating cut. So when your mayors tell you that they're gonna bring housing and that that's what you should focus on instead of the way the police harass, move along, cite and arrest your friends, take their stuff or yourself. When they tell you to wait for housing, tell them housing is a lie. Housing isn't coming in the way that we need housing to come. Housing is a token. Housing is a promise for the future to distract us from the present. Housing is a fucking human right, that's for sure. Housing is a fucking human right, that's for sure. We absolutely need to say it. We absolutely need to be the standard bearer. Housing is a human right. But do we expect the state to provide that to us? Has the state totally abandoned its responsibility to house, help, feed its people? And in that situation, what do we say to the fucking state? I don't know, I don't have one for that. But, yeah.
Right.
So as we see this administration engage in intense class wars, we see a huge shift of wealth once again and again and again, this neoliberal shift of wealth from the very poorest to the very richest. We just have to be engaged. We have to know, we have to say when they're bringing housing to our city, when they're bringing services to our city, we can't let them scapegoat that housing. This was my part in the wall, guys. Subsidized housing lines, all this stuff. That's right, I'm the wall, I forgot. When they bring that to us and they say, decriminalization isn't a solution. They're just distracting. They're just playing a game with our hearts. They're spreading false hope in our communities. How many folks do you know have waited on these lists? How many folks do you know that have waited on these lists and then years later found out they're not on the lists anymore? Right, these lists are a lie and they're false hope in our communities. We need to be building the hope for ourselves, building it for each other, building it in ourselves, right?
Yeah.
Yeah, thanks guys.